All right, what's going on, ladies and gentlemen? What I'm coming to you guys with today is some more Jets franchise here in Madden 15. We're going to be taking on the San Diego Chargers here in week number 5. And in real life, this game is actually just about to happen right now. It's actually 4:18, and the game starts at 4:25. So I'm going to be, right after this commentary, going to go on and watching the Jets game. Let's see how they can do. Hopefully they will win in real life and also in this game, because they've been, in real life, just been struggling mightily so far. But in this game, we're 4-0 so far. So let's see if we can keep it up. As you see, we're going to throw it over to Jeremy Curley to start this game. A pretty good start for Geno Smith, I should say, because Geno Smith in this series has been playing very well so far. Hopefully we can keep it up, though. It's going to be 3rd and 10. We're going to throw it over to Decker, but it's unfortunately not going to get the first down, so we are going to have to punt on our first possession. So we're going to give the ball over to the San Diego Chargers to start this game. And let's see how our defense can play. Our defense has been playing pretty well so far. And Philip Rivers is going to look for a receiver. He's going to hit Ryan Matthews. He's going to make that catch, and he's going to have so much yard. I don't know where the defenders were, who was covering him. I have no idea. So he was wide open in the middle of the field. So again, it's going to be 2nd and 7 coming up now here. Phillip Rivers is going to drop back, look for a receiver. He's going to throw it over to Eddie Royal, I believe that is. He's going to break a tackle, and he's going to go all the way into the end zone for a touchdown. And I don't know what happened here. We had two defenders ready to make the tackle, and I'm not really sure exactly what happened. So that's going to be a touchdown for the San Diego Chargers. They're going to jump out to a 7-0 lead. So here we go, Geno Smith back on offense, throwing it over to Jason Morrow. He'll make that catch, and I believe he'll be about a yard short of the first down. So we're going to have to try and get some little short passes to get ourselves down the field. Hopefully that's going to work for us. We'll see what happens, though, as we throw it over to Jeremy Curley. He makes the catch for another first down. We're down to the 38-yard line now. 3rd and 6 coming up. Geno Smith is going to try to see if he can convert on this. We'll see what happens. He will throw it over to David Nelson to make the catch. And now we're inside the 20-yard line, and we're in the red zone now. Let's see if we can try to finish this, because we have been struggling a little bit in the red zone so far this year. Let's see, though. We're going to throw it over to that. That's going to be Jeremy Curley. He'll make that catch, and he is down on the play. He's injured. He's not moving at all, so hopefully he's going to be all right. He was injured last week and did come back. Hopefully the same thing will happen this time, but he looks like he's in a lot of pain this time. We'll have to see what happens, though. It's going to be 2nd and goal now. We're going to hand it off to Chris Johnson. He's going to get into the end zone for a touchdown, and just like that, we are going to tie this game back up to 7-7. And it looked like we were losing it a little bit, but we did come back, tie the game right here. And uh-oh, look at that, a broken collarbone for Jeremy Curley. And he's not going to be able to return, and I don't know how long he's going to be out for. Hopefully it's not that long, but we definitely need Jeremy Curley back in this lineup soon, because he has been a very, very big part of this team. So anyway, here we go once again. It is going to be now 2nd and 18, 7-7 is the score. And Philip Rivers drops back. He's looking for a receiver. He's going to throw over to the left side of the field. I think number 11 is Eddie Royal. I don't know if he's 11 or 12. I do apologize if it's not Eddie Royal. But anyway, it's going to be 3rd and 7 coming up now on the 20-yard line. Philip Rivers drops back. He's going to look for a receiver. Nobody's open, but there's some great coverage right now going on with the offensive line for the Chargers. And look at that. I don't know what's going on with our defense right now, but we just cannot stop Philip Rivers at all. 1st and goal. It's going to be pretty tough to try to stop him here. And look at that. Ryan Matthews right into the end zone for a touchdown. So they take the lead right back. And I don't know what the problem is. We have been having a lot of problems on defense this year, making some stops. And hopefully that's something that we can fix very soon. If you guys have any suggestions, definitely let me know those in the comments down below. Maybe some different defensive plays that could work. So we're back on offense, trying to tie this game up once again. Geno Smith drops back. He's going to look for a receiver. He's throwing it over to Jason Morrow. It looks like he will make the catch, but he will be about 3 yards short. Yeah, 3 yards short of that first down. So we're now at the 2-minute warning here in the second quarter. Geno Smith out of shotgun. Nobody in the backfield. Is all by himself. He's going to drop back, look for a receiver. He's throwing it over to the right side. That's going to be caught. I believe that was Shaq Evans that makes a catch. And that's a nice catch to get out of bounds. And we're now back around the 10-yard line. Look at Geno Smith on the day. 14 for 17, 138 yards. Not much else you can ask for. So Geno Smith into the end zone. That's going to be a touchdown to Jace Amaru. And Jace Amaru is slowly starting to become a big contributor to this offense. Hopefully we can keep it up. So just like that, we do tie this game up 17-17 now. And let's see if we can stop the Philip Rivers on defense now. He's out of shotgun. He's looking for a receiver. He's throwing it over the field, and that's going to be caught, and that's going to be a huge play. It's going to get down to the 40-yard line, and I just don't know what the problem is. We just cannot make these stops when we really need to make them, and that's going to be a big problem in the future of these games when we play the Patriots or we play the Broncos next week. It's just going to get really, really frustrating very fast. So hopefully we can fix that. Another completion for another first down. It's going to be 1st and goal, but thankfully we did make a stop there. We did not let them score, but they are going to settle for a field goal. So we will go into halftime with the score being 17-14. So it's not too bad. We still are only down by a field goal, so definitely we can come back and make the score touchdown, take that lead. But the Chargers do get the ball in the second half, so we need to make a stop on defense. I don't know what the problem is. In that first half, we just did not do well. Let's see if we can change it here in the second half, as once again, that first play of the game is going to be, they're going to catch it and get down to the midfield right now. So look at Philip Rivers, 15 for 17, 257 yards already on the game. Like, how is that even possible? So once again, a wide open receiver, a busted play by our defense. Once again, I cannot stand this defense, the secondary of this defense right now. We don't have many veterans on the team. We just have D. Milliner. He's our number one. I think Antonio Allen is our number two. I don't know what the problem is. So once again, into the end zone for a touchdown. The Chargers are up by 10 now in this game. The score is 24-14. I don't even know what's going on right now. We really just need to start making some stops on defense. And once again, our offense isn't playing bad at all. There's going to be times that you're going to go three and out. So right there, Geno Smith does get lucky. The defender does drop the interception. So here we go. Back on defense once again. Throwing it over the field. That's going to be, I believe that's Malcolm Floyd. I don't remember. I don't even know the name of the Chargers. I do apologize about that. But just like that, the Chargers are up 31-14. Our defense is just completely shutting down right now. I don't know what the problem is. So anyway, it's going to be 31-14 coming up. Now our offense needs to make some big, get some big plays coming here in the future. Let's see what Geno Smith can do. Throw over the field. That's going to be Jace Amaro. I have no idea how he made that catch. It looked like that ball was going to get intercepted. Somehow it got through. Jace Amaro makes the play. And now it's going to be first and 10 on the 31-yard line. Geno Smith drops back, throwing it over. That's going to be Devin Hester. He makes the catch, and he's going to get down the sideline to this 8-yard line. And yes, I did pick up Devin Hester. I do apologize. I forgot to tell you guys that earlier on. So Devin Hester, he probably will be our return man from now on as well. So I'm looking forward to having Devin Hester on this team. He could even replace Jeremy Curley if he's out for an extended period of time. But look at that. A drop touchdown pass, Jeff Cumberland. And our offense is just struggling. Well, not even struggling right now, but we need to get something going. So we're going to go for it on fourth and goal. Can we get it? We're going to throw it over to Zach Sudfeld. No, we're not going to get that. And it looked like we were going to get a chance. I think we had a better option on the right side of the field. I did not see that at the time, though. So it is going to be a turnover on downs on the 2-yard line. So unfortunately, we do not come away with any points on this drive. I really thought we were going to. But here we go. 3rd and 5 on the 7-yard line. Phillip Rivers drops back. Nick Ballore is going to get the safety just like that. And we do get 2 points on the board. So we didn't get a field goal. We didn't get a touchdown. But we get the safety and we get the ball back as of right now. And that's a pretty good sign right there. Let's see. Geno Smith out of shotgun. Can we try to score a touchdown? We need to start contributing. Throwing it over to Eric Decker. He's going to make that catch. And he's down to the 42-yard line. And we are starting to march down the field once again. 23 for 33. 258 yards on the game for Geno Smith with a touchdown. We can make that 2 touchdowns after this play as we're going to throw it over. That's going to be Eric Decker. And he will get into the end zone. That's another touchdown. And the score is now going to be, I believe it's 31-23 now. So we are definitely into this game. Once again, it's a one possession game, a little under 5 minutes left to go in this game. We do make the Chargers do go three and out, so we get the ball back once again. We throw it over to Devin Hester. He makes that catch, and we are once again into the Chargers territory. So we are only a touchdown and a 2-point conversion away from tying up this game. Geno Smith is going to try and drive this team and lead them to a victory. Let's see if we can do it. We're going to throw it over. That's going to be Jason Morrow. He will make that catch, but he will be a couple of yards short of the first down. But let's see, he has 8 receptions, 76 yards already on the game. And you know what, we're going to give him another reception right here. Throw it into the end zone. That's a touchdown, and we are only a 2-point conversion away from tying up this game as we get another touchdown to Jason Morrow. And he's really going to be probably our go-to man from in the future. So here we go. This is for the tie. 2-point conversion coming up. Geno Smith, he's going to throw it over the middle. No, we're not going to get it. I thought we were going to tie this game up, but unfortunately, we're going to have to go for an onside kick, and we do not get that. And unfortunately, we are going to give the Chargers a chance to run out the clock, but we did manage to stop them. So they are going to kick a field goal. The score is going to be now 34-29. We are down by 5, and we need to find a way to score a touchdown. We're going to have 19 seconds left to play with. Can we do it? We have no timeouts. Let's see what we can do. Coming up is going to be Geno Smith out of shotgun. Let's see what we can do. I really think we have a chance. We'll see, though. We have a man where it's going to be one-on-one coverage down the field, and Geno Smith will underthrow Eric Decker. That's going to be the ball game right there, and we're going to lose by 5 on the play. Final score, 34-29. I thought we were going to have a chance to make a comeback, but we need to find a way to make some more stops on defense. So if you guys have any suggestions, anything that you could tell me to maybe even play better on defense, make sure you let me know those in the comments down below. If you guys did enjoy the video, please make sure you drop a like. As you see, the final score is going to be 34-29. If you guys enjoyed the video, please make sure that you drop a like. We are going to be playing the Denver Broncos next episode. That's going to be another tough game, so we'll have to see what happens. We are now 4-1 on the season. I'll see you guys next time. Hopefully you enjoyed. Have a good day, guys. Peace.